six week, okay. And we will start with George Cantor, very important mathematician, and living in between these dates. His very famous creation of set theory, depending on the George Cantor, and he's very famous actually, especially with the strange attractor chaotic theory and all kind of other things. You do have Cantor numbers, and you can search for it, and you can do your presentation, one of the themes, you can do that. Cantor numbers, and of course strange attractors. Strange attractors is a very challenging topic. Okay, and why he is famous? Because he developed with Dedekind, another mathematician, with set theory. Okay, what is set theory? Firstly, we have to know that this is the Rostow notation. What does the Rostow notation? It means in parentheses, curly parentheses. This is the Rostow notation, and this is the element signal. Is element of, this is called is element of, right? This is called is element of S. A is element of S. B is element of omega. Or this one is not element of S. This is the very simple notation. This is not element of, okay? This is very important. And as well, this is the another notation for representing the sets. A could be represented by X is element of S and satisfying PX predicate. Or proposition or whatever the PX is. It doesn't matter, okay? And in rule-based definition. And subsets is very simply is defining if X is element of A, then X is element of B. This is if that statement. Negation is therefore existential because this is for all X. What the negation of for all X is, of course, there exists X such that X is element of A. And is not element of B, it's not included, not covered by B. It's not covered by B in English notation. Not covered by B. This is covered. Let me clearly written here. This notation, just here, is not covered by B, right? Okay. So, proper subset and other definition, you can easily follow the examples here and proofs here, it doesn't matter. There is a definition other than Rostow notation, this is 6R plus 12 or 3S. Very simply, you have to define the R and S. What is it? Is here is R is Z. Z is integer. We know that. Integers. Okay. That's, you can do it anytime. But rational numbers or whatever the set is here. And proofs are can be followed by this definition, and you can see that we'll do in the class. And set equality is very important because of some classes we have to define. Class means set of sets, okay? Class of sets. Some definition in this chapter and the relations chapter, we do need this kind of definition. very important. Let's put a parenthesis and exclamation mark here. Quality and proof. And Venn diagrams are very famous with Jonna. And when we define the intersection, union, and all other subsets, these are the subsets, these are the intersection, these non-disjoint sets, this is disjoint. Disjoint sets. The subsets notation, this equality, etc. And very famous relations in a set of integers, rationals, and real numbers, as I did in the class. I use this Venn diagram, could be rectangular, not all the time circular one, it doesn't need it. It's not necessary. And this is, you know, Q, subset is Z, is integers, and subset is natural numbers, and this is irrational numbers. All of this set is real numbers. This is another representation. Okay, what is I here? Irrational numbers. We do know that. And E, pi, and square root of anything, you know, in any prime number is irrational. And Pema has definition, universal set, universal of discourse, and union, intersection, and difference, and complement is well defined, symbolically represented here. Very important. This notation first used by the Pema, this U and this notation, you know, union and intersection and difference and complement. Sometimes complement, we are using this notation as well. With bar, you know, bar notation. Alright? And intervals are important. We will do in the class. Why it's important? Because definition of the functions in the next chapter, following chapters, and relation is based on intervals. We will do it in the class. Sometimes we are using this infinite notation. This is a very complicated one for advanced mathematics, but we will see. This is an important one as well. This notation, mathematicians should know that. And very important for applied mathematics. Interval important for the definition of functions and relations. Okay? What is empty set? Is a null set. In English, very important, null. Nullity, null space. Null is a very important concept. Empty set, of course. There is no element, and you cannot assign any element in empty set. It's called empty set. Okay. Do you have any intersection between these two sets? No, it's empty set. Is there any real number? Square of this real number is minus 1, it's impossible, and this is empty set as well, with no elements. That's the definition. Yeah, a set with no elements is empty set. Partition is very important for computational geometry and all computer graphics, and mechanical engineering and electrical engineering. And sets are called disjoint if and only if they have no elements. The intersection is empty set. In one diagram, let me represent this one. For example, if we have the universal set like that, then you divide two, A and B, and you can divide C and D. This is the finite partition of any universal set. This is blah blah. This is called finite partition. What is the definition of partition? It's any disjoint set is any disjoint subset is called partition. Okay. Any. This could be, you know, these two could be any subset here. That's, for example, this and this as well, this is a subset, or this individual one, this one could be subset, or these two are called subset. It doesn't matter. Any subset means it could be anything here, finite partition. It's used a lot in the computational geometry. But sometimes we call these chunks as mutually exclusive. It's very important definition for mathematics. Mutually exclusive or mutually disjoint or non-overlapping sometimes. Mutually disjoint sets like this one, partition set. This is called some literature is called mesh, right? Mesh. Let me write it in capital letter as well. Meshing is very important. Partitioning. A power set is very important concept. It's used a lot in the probability theory and graph theory or other discrete mathematic theory. Okay, continue with this one. Power set of a set is very simply if we have XY element of a set, power set is just empty set. Every time power set including zero element empty set and of course itself. All other rest is defined by one element subset, two element subset, zero element subset, this one zero element, this is n element subset, etc. Okay, we will see that. Ordered pair is very important for the couple of next weeks. It's very simply if A, B, C, D is ordered pair, or sometimes we have ordered triple, but this is a very rare case, but this is important. If A equal to C and B equal to D is called ordered pair. And ordered n-tuples, Cartesian product, very important. I think previous weeks we covered this one. The important thing in the Cartesian product, first element should belong to the first set, the second element should belong to the second set. When the multiple products, you should solve the inside the parentheses and then continue, okay? And you can partition whenever you like that. Or this is a triple product and it's belong to the first set, you see, x, y, 1, 2, 3, and a, b. X, 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 y, y, y. X, 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 Y, Y. Because this is 1A, 2A, 3A. This is 1A, 2A, 3A. And every time it's changing, right? 1B, 2B, 3B, 5B. And this is the way Cartesian product can be represented. Inclusion of intersection, inclusion in union, transitive property subsets, which could be derived easily with the Venn diagram, of course. You can work on it. This is the set definitions in another way, another notation. Right. These identities are important, commutative, associative and distributive is used a lot, identity, and union with empty set is itself, intersection with universal set is itself again. and complement. U is universal set, the biggest set what we have. And double complement, it unpotent means we are getting the same set, it doesn't matter what we do. Universal bound loss and etc. De Morgan is very important. De Morgan is very, very important, okay? Good. That sets are equal, okay. Proof of De Morgan. You can find the proof of every distinct identity over there. An empty set by proof by contradiction is very good proof actually. Proof of conditional statement, etc. It's given repetition of the previous weeks. And it's useful exercise for you, obviously. And Venn diagram and Rostrum notation you should learn very, very well. Number of subsets is very important. I show you in the class, this is a 2 to the n, right? Maybe we have to do it again. And how can it be related with 2 to the n? Please note that. And work on it. It's related with binomial expansion. Binomial expansion. This is the question for you. How can we can relate this one, binomial expansion and subset theory, okay? As power set. Please write it down and I will check it in the class. What has been 2 to the n number of subsets? Why, how can it be like that? What's the proof of that, etc. Alright? It's related with, this proof is not including the binomial expansion, but I need that. Alright? Do it in a way I define this one. Alright. So, driving set difference, etc. We will do that. General associative law and Boolean algebra and Russell products and Halting problem. It is the way the set theory is very famous nowadays. Since the Boolean algebra is the main algebra and underlying theory for the computers and logic, digital logic. Digital logic and the light towards Boolean algebras. Russell paradox is about the contradiction in mathematics can be solved or not solved with Halting problem and with but it, we have to talk about the Kurt Gödel, famous German mathematician, about the incompleteness theorem. So search for incompleteness theorem and bring it to the class, okay? Incompleteness theorem, very, very important. Try to understand and try to teach your friends or me. What is the incompleteness theorem? Could go there. Second or first incompleteness theorem. It's very important. Okay, the second question. What was the first question? It's about the binomial expansion, the proof of this one. It's regular binomial expansion, okay? So this definition of Boolean algebra set properties related with this one. Every time we can say OR means union, AND means intersection. This is definitions and try to understand topology as universal set, contradiction is empty set, and use this analogy to understand well for both logic and the set properties. Talk about in the class. Boolean algebra, we will talk about that. It is very important. How can it be the main underlying theory? Just digital electronics and computers. And it's very important. Digital logic. Digital logic. Computers. Based on Boolean algebra. Okay. Even they gave the name one of the George Boole relatives to the programming languages. Properties of Boolean algebra, very important. We'll talk about in the class. It's based on the binary operations, okay? What does mean by 0 and 1? Only 0 and 1, alright? We can see that in the class. Because this is binary, okay? Binary system and logic. It's important for us. Russell Paradox, but Russell is very important mathematician and was a philosopher and a very famous professor of the Oxford Cambridge University, and who took the Heidegger to the university, and it changed a lot of things in the philosophy, history of the philosophy. He's a very important person. He has this history of philosophy, etc., bindings. Many books, and he's saying contradiction in the mathematics can be solved or can be handled. But as opposed to Bertrand Russell, Kierkegaard says there is no way you can get rid of the contradiction from the mathematics. This is your homework, incomplete story. Very important mathematician. As opposed to Bertrand Russell. We say incomplete story. Search for it and try to understand and teach us. And why it is important? Because it shows us there is no way you can prove mathematics itself is a contradictive thing. You cannot get rid of the contradiction from the mathematics. It's very despair, but on the contrary, mathematics has improved after this contradiction claim. You cannot get rid of the mathematics from the theory contradiction. So proof is very strange. Please try to find the proof of this theorem, okay? It's very important. One of the team can prepare this theorem in the, at the end of the semester. Because you are a you will be a mathematician as well, and you have to think about what is the contradiction in general with mathematics. Mathematics cannot be proved by free of contradictions. This is very important. This is free of contradictions. It is not possible to prove. This is the theorem's claim. Yeah, it's not possible to prove mathematics is free of contradictions. So, what does it mean? It means, even though we are using axioms, theorems, lemmas, and conjectures, the way mathematical logic and proof, direct proof or indirect proof, or proof by contradiction, etc., doesn't matter. And we cannot get rid of the contradictions from the mathematics. A very famous Turing machine problem, Hamming problem, there's no way you can prove as well, this is almost the same in computer, no way you can say this algorithm halts or loops forever. There is no computer algorithm, right? This is the important. There is no computer algorithm. Yeah, this is very important. This is the uncertainty or inconclusive. Mathematics is inconclusive in terms of these problems. We cannot prove that this algorithm has will be static or loops forever, work for till infinity. It's very difficult problems. Okay, this hardcore of the mathematics is relating with this one. Maybe a couple of one team can prepare this halting problem. with the previous lecture with algorithms, definition of algorithm, and including there's a good presentation topic here. Please search for it. What is the algorithm definition? Please bring it to me. Who invented? What is the halting problem? Okay, group by contradiction is written here, but you can have a lot of repository in the internet. Check the internet. Okay, this is called halting problem, or very famous halting problem, or let's say infinite loop halting problem. It's much better try to understand NP-NP. What is this concept? This is the TOR project, or presentation topic, very important one. Okay, I hope you will do that. But voluntary basis or whatever you want, it doesn't matter. Okay, this is the end of the 5th and 6th week. It's very short. You have to think about halting problem and prepare some presentation. Incompleteness theorem and proof effect and Russell's products as well. But you have to compare with Russell's products with Kurtjebe's incompleteness theorem. Here you have to compare the algorithm definition, invention, halting problem, and PN and PP completeness. This is very important. And completeness problem. Completeness. Search for the completeness, NP, okay? These are two different topics for your presentation. And Boolean algebra is very important. You can prepare, one of you, you can prepare the Boolean algebra and digital logic. A good topic. You do have to, more than 20 students, we need to add more problem or presentation topic and activation, active participation. You can talk about that in the class, and you can choose your topic on behalf of the, your friends or team leader, whatever yourself. It can be individual presentations. It doesn't matter. Just tell me in the class. We will decide details of the topics. We can discuss, or you can prepare and discuss. I prefer you prepare the topics and we can discuss in the class, okay? Choose your team or whatever your options. Just tell me. Okay? Then this week or next week we will finalize the presentation. Okay? Set theory is very, very important. The very center of the mathematics. Special discrete mathematics. Think about the theory of computing. Think about the algorithms. Think about the parameter. Think about the all learning algorithms. Sets are indispensable tools to move forward in topological mathematics. Higher mathematics is still doing it. Sets, okay. So Cantor, very good topic. Try to understand Cantor numbers. It's a hard topic, but you can do it, one of you. It's related with the Cantor theory. You can search for it in the internet. Okay? Cantor theory and finite dimensional strange attractors. Like, for example, very famous one, let me write it for you. Lorentz. Rossler. And actually these are the, these strange attractors are the Cartesian product of Rubin and Cantor numbers. So strange, right? Search for it, try to understand each, what does it mean Rubin, what does it mean Cantor numbers. know the Cartesian product, okay? What is a strange attractor? Search for it. Thanks a lot.